just don't make sense, and you need a friend. Grab a hand and come aboard. It's a special place called the...
I'm not telling you the name yet. You just have to wait here. You just have to wait for the...
Ducks. It's called the William Street Swap Shop. It's called the William Street Swap Shop.
Hello, welcome to the William Street Swap Shop. My name is Zach, and joining me soon will be my co-host Matt. He just went up to the mall to get, I think, had an Apple Store run, had to go visit the Genius Bar. So here I am, just holding in for him for the show. Welcome to the Swap Shop. If you have any items you would like to swap, please call in at 413-961-4263. Oh, and I think Matt's coming on in now. Come on, Matt.
Hey, man. Sorry about that.
Oh,
sorry,
cool.
I'm running late.
You got my computer. Did they fix it?
Yeah. He said that...
Here, let me get the
chair. I felt so bad about what happened last week.
Be careful of the cords.
Yeah. He felt so bad about what happened. I did. And so I took it up to the Genius Bar. And they said it's cool. It just had a little damage from the water.
Oh, no.
It's okay. I was digitizing all... It should be fine still. I was digitizing the Showmasters.
Matt, you gotta get it together, man.
All right, sorry, man.
We can't. We have our table just got off the markers. We gotta move it back to our markers.
Okay, sorry about that.
And my computer.
You know what? This can wait. We'll just. Figure it out later. Is the computer working again, or is it?
Was it working when you brought it here? Did you check it before you came?
Yeah, I mean, they had to load some like drivers onto it, but.
Dude, this is the second time this has happened. Well, maybe this afternoon I'll take it to the Genius Bar and I'll speak to them.
Would you mind? I would feel really embarrassed like going back there after that.
Why?
You know, when you go like twice in one day.
You know, they teach you to take good care of your electronics there. And when I one time had a crack on my computer screen, I fixed it, and I said, I will never do this again. I will treat you so well. And then, well...
I know that was...
Let's just... I'm not going to be able to look at the internet.
Your dad had
to save
up...
I can't look at the Twitch comments or the
Adult Swim
chat
comments. That whole
year
before freshman college year when he had to save up to buy that laptop, and I know it's really important to you... I apologize for that.
Well, it's okay. I accept your apology.
Big distraction. I'm sorry. It's time to start the show. We did a thing this lunch where we ate, and then I went to the bathroom, and now I'm ready to do the show.
Well, thanks for trying to take it to the Apple Store, I guess. Glad that the water damage was fixed, and maybe now it's just something, you know, maybe a driver or a CPU got banged around or something.
I think the cool thing is that we know the water damage is not the problem anymore. So if something goes wrong, it's probably the dropping it today. So you can sort of give them that extra little bit of information.
Okay. Well, even though starting off on a sour note, let's intro the show and get on with it. We have a lot of things to discuss.
We've got a lot of new stuff, a lot of things to discuss. And
it's a deal.
It's a deal. We want to welcome you. It's the William Street Swap Shop.
As I was saying before Matt stepped in and dropped my laptop on the floor, we are a swap shop. We swap your items. You send in images of things that you would like to trade with other swappers. And they don't always have to be things. They can be humans. They can be ideas, thoughts, advice, stories, or any anything else that's tangible.
Compliments for us, and then we compliment you back and forth for an hour. It can be family photos that are too painful for you. You want to get rid of them. You give them to us, and we'll, riff on them on the show. Now, this is a controversial. We had our first human swap last week. We've got another human. And I hope he's consenting to this, but Mallory's friend, Nathan, the net developer, is up for swap.
It's sounds a nice like image of Nathan. Curly hair.
Yeah.
Looks like he can grow a nice beard if he were to let it grow out. Brown eyes. Are those blue eyes? And nice eyebrows.
He seems like he's open to your ideas. He's not going to come in and tell you how you're supposed to run your gear. He says, you tell me what the problem is. I'm going to listen. We're going to check your IP address. If that doesn't work, we're going to check your Ethernet port and make sure that the drivers are up to date on that.
I promise I will not mess around your settings on your Mac. I know you like them a particular way. I will not go in and change things and screw it all up and make you have to relearn it all again like some other tech people. I'm a tech wizard, and I got my bachelor's degree. We're assuming as a net developer,
I would assume he's got at least a bachelor's degree. But if he doesn't, we're taking him off the shop and just be unfair to people. And then he says he gives Mallory her laptop back, and he says, simple restart seemed to fix it this time. Hey, what are you up to this weekend? No reason. No, yeah. Oh, yeah. That probably will be fun. No, I'll see you Monday. It's been a pleasure fixing your internet-related technical issues. Please don't swap me.
So do you think Mallory has Nathan tranquilized right now and waiting to be swapped, or is he willing and he's just waiting for a new life?
He's willing. He's confident. He probably initiated this, and I think Nathan's got a good future on the swap shop.
Right. It's embarrassing if you post a picture of yourself up on the swap shop and say, hey, I want to be traded. You know, I'm ready to be swapped. It's great when you ask a friend to do it for you, so it looks like they are trying to swap you, so it increases your value. No one wants to swap someone, you know, when you're self-swapping.
It's vulgar to swap yourself. If you are Nathan, or Mallory for that matter, and you want to fill us in on the backstory, sometimes people, they're reluctant to swap for a human if they don't have confirmation it's not against his will. So Nathan, give us a call. How do you feel about this? Are you satisfied with your life? Are you thinking, hey, maybe there's a new adventure out there somewhere in Uzbekistan or wherever a swapper might be located that wants to take you home and put you in an area beneath their staircase?
You look like a nice young man, someone easy to get along with, good looking, you have a great job. Business, everybody knows the new form of business is all on the net, and it's all developing for websites, and you knew that when you got your degree, and you knew that when you got your career, and now you're set for the future. You'll never have to worry about losing your job. The only thing you'll have to worry about is, what do I do with all this extra money?
I'll be Nathan back when I was in school, and you asked me what I'm majoring in.
Okay. Am I future Nathan, or am I just your colleague?
Sure, you're future Nathan, traveling through time, asking me what I'm majoring in, even though you already know.
Hey, Nathan, this is your future self. What are you majoring in right now?
Well, I'm majoring in e-commerce with a minor in Spanish.
Huh. Have you ever thought about changing it?
Every once in a while I do. But I got an idea about maybe just doing some net development. A lot of e-commerce is really emerging on these new platforms, and I think it's going to position me well.
Well, I have nothing but great things to say about net developing. If you did not want to net develop, what would be your other option?
Something with my hands, maybe carpentry. I just like fixing problems for people.
Great.
My best friend in the world.
You sound
Mallory.
Like you're going to grow up to be, you're going to have a great life. I can tell you this. Stay on the current path. I'm your future self. I know it. I'm off now.
Whoosh. On Easy Street. Mallory, it's Nathan. I know you want to swap me, but I wanted to wait for a special moment to ask you this. And now's the time. The swap shop has meant so much to us through our young adult years, and I thought there'd be no better place to ask you than right now. Will you? Please, make me the happiest net developer on the planet and accept my proposal to start carpooling to work together. Don't answer right away. Send me an email. Your email should be working again. I just fixed it.
Please say yes, Mallory.
All right. Nathan, give us a call. Let us know the real story. Till then, we're going to assume that everything we just did was accurate.
Correct. And don't forget, we have a husband, Ken, available to swap. So, Mallory, if you'd like to trade Nathan for Ken, that is a possible deal we could go do. Our next item here is a Canadian dollar. These are worth, I think, $5. The U.S. dollar is...
fluctuates between $5 and $7 U.S. dollars, right, for a Canada dollar.
U.S. dollar is very moving up. You know, it's starting to do really well.
Yeah. We tend to be, you know, 500-600% the Canadian behind the Canadian dollar. That's why a house in Canada only costs like $20,000.
Right.
American.
Makes sense.
So, you guys, if you missed it, we did a whole tribute to Canada. You know all about what a great country it is. They've got an awesome new prime minister. He's very handsome. And there's not more. We can't really say good enough things about Manitoba,
a lot of
Alberta,
great provinces.
All the great provinces
and
up
territories.
There.
Looking to move to Canada soon? This is a great starter kit. People will tell you, why are you going to Canada? You don't have anything invested in it. And you can pull out this coin and say, yes, I do. I have a Canada dollar. And watch their eyes light up.
If you are the Canadian Prime Minister and you want 5 minutes of free digital streaming time to advance your one-sided political agenda for the Canada's future, call us. We'll let you talk about it. But you have to prove you're the real prime minister and not just some phony.
Right. Justin, give us a call, bro.
Is it really Justin?
I think so.
Justin
Trudeau.
LePage or something? Yeah, something kind of French.
We used to play, I think he used to play hacky sack. We could talk some sack.
And the next item we got up here, we got so many items this week. It's like the shelves are weighing under the weight of all the
call items. From.
That's right.
Hello, is this Nathan?
No.
Okay.
Sorry.
Hello, you're on live in the swap shop. Come on in.
Come on in.
Well,
I just was taking a guess, but you're welcome, whoever you are.
I noticed on the silver dollar that the person swapping it is Kyle, and that kind of made me think, have you guys, like, found him yet?
Oh, that's a great question. Zach's twin brother, Kyle.
I haven't heard back.
Last seen in the woods.
Last we'd heard was he was naked and cold, and, you know, we warned him, do not go out there. Hopefully we'll have an update from him soon. Sometimes our internet here is actually, you would think it's really great, but we actually have a lot of issues with it. So maybe we'll get it fixed when we're not allocating it all to broadcasting our show.
Fingers crossed.
Yes.
Where are you calling from? Sounds like a call center of some kind. Are you doing calls? Oh, he's gone.
He just wanted to find out about Kyle. I know a lot of people are worried about him, but, you know, one good brother is still here. That's me.
You know, Kyle is a survivor, and I think that no matter what comes his way, he ends up sort of making the most of things. So we'll see. Maybe tomorrow we'll hear from him once he gets some Wi-Fi signal again. But
we can only hope.
Yeah. I know it's complicated for you because he's always sort of overshadowed you, and now there might be no more Kyle. And I'm sure probably some based on some of the things you've said, the authorities would look at you early on if you were, like, to go missing. Or
I mean, we have alibis. I've been here at the studio, Matt, the entire time. You know I very rarely leave work. I'm a workaholic.
I always tell them, you need to take a few days off, Zach. Get out of here. Clear your head, man. You're in a little too deep on the swap scene. Never listens. Just gets back down there inventorying.
That's right. Send us an email to williams.swap@gmail.com. I see it. I'm online checking it out. So don't be shy. Send some items. I'll read it. I'll look at it. Let's take a look back at our paddle board here. Next item being swapped by Decree, one of the best swappers in the swap shop.
A rising star in the swap shop.
He's got a paddle ball board, giving it a kiss like always.
It's his signature. If you are someone who likes, you know, sports with balls, but hey, why do my balls always keep going missing? You don't like the responsibility of an untethered ball? Give paddleball a try. It's something, it's not for everybody. It takes a lot of hand-eye coordination. But one thing that'll never happen is that your ball will always stay affixed to the paddle. That's why Zach likes it.
It's a fun game to play by yourself. You do things alone a lot? Well, stop worrying about trying to invite other people over and just start focusing on how you can enjoy your time better. Paddleball is a great sport to start learning by yourself.
I was never very good at sports. It was not something that was real easy for me to have to deal with in junior high. And when I see a paddle ball, it kind of brings me back to that moment. And it's not really the funnest thing for me to look at. I guess I sort of retreated into my books, you know.
Yeah.
And my music.
You're really into music, I remember you telling me. A lot of new metal.
I think I found something sort of in the aggression of new metal that really spoke to me and what I was feeling at the time, having failed to, you know, to make the basketball team and to get dates and all that sort of stuff. But
look at you now, Matt. I bet you got 5 different people who commented on you when you went up to the Genius Bar. They said, there's the local international celebrity. Used to be local, but now international because the swap shop is such a big brand. Look at him coming into the Apple store, just like everybody else, getting his device fixed. I wonder what kind of images he has on that computer. Where's his partner, Zach? I bet he's working hard at the swap shop. That Zach is a hard worker.
They don't let Zach out. Why doesn't Zach ever come to the Genius Bar? I don't know. Someone commented on an eyebrow hair I need to trim last show. And I agree. And I was thinking I'd trim it on the air, but I forgot to bring tweezers today. So we'll save that for tomorrow.
Why not bring a big pair of scissors and just cut it?
I could. I actually screen grabbed their comment, and I want to do like a dubstep remix of their comment while I trim my eyebrow hair. There it is. Sometimes it sits down, sometimes it stands up.
I'm aiming to grow my eyebrows out. So right now they comb back, but then if I ever want to spike it up, like I used to spike up my hair,
yeah,
I'll spike up my brows.
You know what I'll do tomorrow is pluck it, and then I'll shave a line in my eyebrows for style purposes.
It's a new cool thing to do. Well, there's cool things to do.
Yeah.
One of the new cool things I like to do is look at items in the swap shop from 1 to 2 p.m. every day.
Here's Decree. You notice this is a more tender kiss he's giving to this one.
Almost as if he's smelling the M&Ms trapped inside their prison.
Inside there.
I smell you. I want to eat you. I'm going to give you a kiss and send you on your way.
They're Star Wars M&Ms, so it means that they're highly collectible. I'm sure these were very limited supplies were created for this promotion. Make a swap for it. Something valuable. The orange one is Jar Jar Binks. A beloved character in modern folklore. I think we should move. We'll come back to Decree, but it might be too much Decree for everybody. We'll give them a little slideshow of the multiple Decree kisses.
Magic 8-Balls and some more shirts. He really is a powerful swapper.
We'll come back. We won't skip those completely, but there's
so many.
We
did get a lot of new items.
We got about 15 new things. This is Go, the signed Go Radio CD from Patrick.
Is Go Radio...
Is it a platform?
I think
it's a streaming service? Is it a band?
Those are the band members that signed the horseshoe. Or it might be a streaming service, and those are the executives of the streaming service.
It's a streaming service named Go Radio. Those are the VPs of distribution and sales who've signed the CD. Big time players in the digital streaming of music people don't like game.
Big time record executives. And about 40 years from now, when they're making TV shows about the decade we currently live in, there will be a show called Streaming, similar to the new one on HBO called Vinyl.
That's
and
right.
It will be about Go Radio, their department, and the rivalries and challenges they faced.
And Go Radio's logo even looks like HBO Go a little bit.
Right.
So you're halfway there.
There will be a scene in the series where they all sign the CD, and then they trade it on the swap shop. We will be very big in the future. People will know about us.
And the executives are all leaning over one laptop, and they're like, what's the stock price?
We need to stream more music.
We need to stream more music and get that stock price up.
People love listening to streaming.
This whole Go Radio operation's going bust.
People need to listen to their music on their devices. We need to stream to them. They don't want to download it. They want to stream it. I'm streaming it, and I'm screaming it.
Is that the tagline for the Go Radio documentary on HBO? Streaming it and screaming it, Go Radio. When heaven said they couldn't, hell said they could.
Four record executives streaming and gleaming. It takes a team to put together this stream.
Everybody who's ever streamed music, they all have a fond memory of the early days of Go Radio. They're like, Spotify, it just made it too easy. I liked back when it was Go Radio and I had to just wait for a band. It's just like real radio, except less convenient.
Well, if you notice the logo, it's an upside-down U. Also a horseshoe. But a lot of people don't know this, but a fact about this is Uber took their logo from this and flipped it upside down. It was that popular in the time period when this came out. That's why they signed it, and that's why it's a big deal, and that's why it's probably one of the best items we have in the swap shop.
And that's why to this day, when you open your Uber app, their logo is a horseshoe.
So you need to, if you're a fan of music, you need to get on this. It's just like those AOL free trials that you used to get at Blockbuster. This is what we're talking about. I'd say this is probably one of the items of the year.
Let's go over. Can we just stop on this area where two different pieces of wood meet? It's not for swap, but it's just interesting to me. It's like sometimes you get so caught up in the everyday you don't stop to notice, like, what if anything was possible? Two different kinds of wood, put them together, and maybe that's the thing you look at. Just a thought.
Sometimes it's not about the items.
Right. It's like jazz. So we got original Nintendo DS. That stands for diminutive supply. They right. only made small amounts of it.
Quantity two.
See? All two. He has both of them.
Look
the
at the little piece of wood that we just brought up in that.
Nintendo DS's.
That was it. They only made two, and as Matt said.
Diminutive supply. They only made two, and Patrick's got both of them. So get the complete set.
This one looks a little worn, though. I don't... Unless this was a paint job done by Nintendo to make it look rustic.
Distressed, yeah.
Right. I like wearing ripped jeans when I go to rock concerts, but I don't like my electronics looking like they've been damaged.
They used reclaimed plastic for the to make it look like more authentic. They took the plastic off an old like boat that had been out in the seawater for a long time.
Makes you feel like you're playing Nintendo and you're actually captaining that ship in that video game.
We got our another entry into the swap shop. Come on in.
Hello, welcome to the swap shop.
Hey guys.
How's it going?
It's going pretty well. It's Nolan.
Nolan, what's up?
Nice.
Not much, man. Just I sent in a couple items that I have up for swap. I just sent them in, so I'm sure it hasn't been gotten to yet. But
Nolan, do you mind shutting the door?
Do you mind just it's like sticking
bells.
Today.
Oh.
Can you
yeah, sorry about that.
It's okay. There we go.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you. So you had a new item?
Yeah,
I have a porcelain cheese plate with a cheese knife. And then a Star Trek DVD season one of the Next Generation.
Wow. Who's your favorite TNG character?
Oh, it's gotta be Data.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What Definitely. Qualities about him do you like that you wish you could have?
Well, I mean, just you know, I'm a techie, so the idea of, you know, just being able to have all knowledge and lack of empathy, I guess.
So his lack of empathy is something you're into.
Well, it's intriguing, yeah.
Now, is that a shucking knife for an oyster?
Well, I use it for cheese. I suppose you could shuck with it.
You could have said, Nolan, when Matt asked that, you could have said "we." It is, because it's "we." Yes.
"We." Yeah.
"We" means yes in French for those that are not familiar with that term.
Can we call it
"we"?
Can we pretend this is a Nintendo "we"?
We can.
Since we're doing Nintendo stuff today.
Right.
So, Nolan, you're in San Antonio and things are really looking up. I saw there was like an article, like 10 best places for young millennials to own an apartment.
San Antonio
building
is on there.
Yeah, it's really trending upwards. And I think that the taco thing really got some traction. I think you guys played a big role in that.
I think you're right on the money there.
I think so.
Ever since... I did a Google alert on San Antonio after we did our taco thing, and the line graph just keeps spiking upward and upward and upward.
Yeah, the hashtags and the retweets are really, really gaining some steam.
What's it like on the ground there? Can you sense like a sort of a new element moving in? That's just
yeah, it's palpable. You can really feel it. Yeah, it's a lot of people talking about tacos and how terrible Austin is and that kind of thing.
Well,
you guys have any big balloon releases where you release a bunch of balloons all at once?
Well, Fiesta's coming up, which is a pretty big event where it's like they have a big flower parade and it's just like a big, you know, Mexican party down the street in San Antonio and up and down the Riverwalk.
Nice.
I'm sure balloons will be released.
Hey, Nolan, maybe you could stay on the line. I think we should talk about the Jacques Bolo Mitzvah.
And, yeah.
As you know, next week I'm not going to be around, so Jacques will be taking my place.
Well, where?
Yeah, your paperwork got confused.
Right. Wasn't there something wrong
with
that? Just explain to the audience.
It's just legal stuff. I could bore you with the details, but, you know, legal stuff, not making deadlines, that kind of thing, and just sort of a...
Right.
So, Matt, you're out all next week.
I'll be out next week. Yeah, I'll be just... not able to make it to the show. And so we got Jacques lined up for a boloing.
We're not 100%.
But first he's got to do is, it's a new ritual we've created for the swap
right.
shop called the Bolo Mitzvah.
Yes.
Nice.
And we made a little video and a little graphic about what has to happen next. So So
okay.
So stand by. You can't okay. see it, but. Okay, so we got a graphic up. You can't see it right now. But
no.
Jacques, in order to become Boloed, he's got to earn his Bolo rewards points.
Mm-hmm.
And he's right at like 74% of how many points he needs.
So he's almost there.
Yeah.
But I don't want to do this show alone next week, so I'm really hoping Jacques can get it up to 100.
Yeah.
So what do you think, like the final sort of feat of strength or challenge for Jacques to get him over 100 should be to win some Bolo points.
To get Bolo points, man, that's a good question. Let me think. What's a good feat to earn your Bolo?
While you think about this, Nolan, just keep in mind this is the first time in the Swap Shop's history that one of the co-hosts has left. Usually both parties are here every day, Monday through Friday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so he needs probably defensive skills, or at least maybe like a hatchet throwing, like something like that, to show his rugged skills of manliness to earn the Bolo.
Yeah, like a hatchet throwing, or some sort of splitting of wood, some firewood.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, like chopping wood or throwing a hatchet at a log and trying to get it to land on a target. I don't know.
That's a good idea, because in Matt's neighborhood, anytime a tree falls down, he's the first one at the person's house. If there's storm damage, he said, "Hey, I'll cut up your wood for you, and I'll sell it for firewood."
Splitting the wood into smaller pieces of wood. wood.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you vote.
You vote. Chop. Split some wood. Wood splitting.
Yeah, splitting wood and just kind of like outdoor feats of strength, like maybe like log throwing or something like that.
Yeah. Okay.
Would you like to address Jacques in sort of a short and sweet way and tell him something about you got to split that wood, dog?
Jacques, yeah, I got this. All right. Jacques, I know you got it in you, buddy, but to get those final Bolo points, you're going to need to split some wood and throw some hatchets.
Sounds good.
Jacques, you think you can do that?
Yeah.
We'll open it up to you, Jacques. What do you think you should have to do for the last 24% of your Bolo point rewards?
And just remember, you got time to think about it.
I would say volunteer my time chewing food for the toothless.
Okay.
Sounds like a great idea.
I didn't see that coming, but yeah, that would work.
Yeah.
You want to say that again, and I'll just bass drop after it?
Yeah, I will. Volunteer my time chewing food for the toothless.
Yeah, that had a nice like meter to it, like rhythm. All right. Well,
score
Nolan,
set.
Man, always
right,
a
well,
pleasure to hear from you out
thanks,
of San Antonio.
Nolan.
Yeah, you too.
We'll throw your items
you
up
guys
in the
have
gallery.
A great one.
Thank you. You too.
All right. Bye.
See you. Put up his items in the swap shop, and we're on a roll. Lots of new items today. Too many to count.
I know. I feel jammed up, like I got to stay on top of the schedule today, which
it's
is not
very,
our usual.
Usually it's very, we relax. And Matt, I apologize if I've been off today, but I've been thinking a lot. My mind right now is on this laptop.
I think it'll be all right.
So I just hope that we can get it fixed and I can get back to working on my spreadsheets. And
if there's one thing I know, it's that the people at the Genius Bar take care of stuff really well and quickly, so you'll be all right.
Hopefully.
Well, what else should we get into? Oh, you know, yesterday we put a challenge out there. We said the first five people to send us JPEGs.
Oh, that was Tuesday.
Right.
Yesterday
I spoke to
a psychic medium.
That's right. I always forget about Wednesdays. But we put out a JPEG challenge, and it's still open, I'm happy to say. We said five people send us a picture of yourself and tell us one good thing about yourself, and we'll promote you on the show, and you can use it on your LinkedIn page. And we had our first JPEG challenge winner. or recipient, was friend of the show, Tony.
Tony.
And he says that he's good at climbing stuff. So we got some budget together for it, and we put this video, promotional video for Tony. He's good at climbing. It's called Tony, colon, he's good at climbing. Hey, man, do you want to go throw frisbee or something later? No, man, I'm Tony, and the thing I do is I climb.
It's cold out, but it's not going to stop me. Put my hood up, I'm going to go climbing. Plenty of good trees to climb, but why not climb this stone? Tombstone. I'm legit. I'm not afraid of anybody.
Are there ghosts in this graveyard? Probably. But guess what? My climb fever blinds me to peril.
Some people think I'm just some kid, but guess what? I'm a grown dude. I'm working hard. What I'm getting at, I make a lot of money, and I have hobbies. One of those hobbies, climbing.
My other hobby? Desecrating monuments to famous war heroes of my hometown. Sergeant Clydesdale, who led the sailors to this land in the early 1800s.
You think I look cool, right? That's right. Got a haircut scheduled later. I'm not wearing gloves. You can tell it's kind of cold outside. I like striped hooded sweatshirts. I like listening to rap music.
And I belong to over 17 rewards programs from local retailers in my hometown. Look it up. It's a fact.
Tony, congratulations on being the first winner of the Swap Shop JPEG Challenge. We still have 4 more spots open. So if you're a viewer who is good at doing something, please snap a pic. Send it on our way to williams.swap@gmail.com, and Matt and I will endorse your coolness.
That's right. And I should mention, it was a tie. Chelsea also sent us something. But I think, Chelsea, we're going to need any kind of photo with you in it. It can be blurry if you're shy. It can be turned looking away at birds if you want to be mysterious. But in order for a proper JPEG challenge, I think the person should be in the photo.
We need to see evidence that you are a real human. You exist. You're not... malware.
A spirit.
Or a spirit. One thing I think we need to get to, Matt, is we had a potential swap.
That's right.
And I believe
even more.
It's still on the table.
It's still on the table. Let's run it. Potential swap. We're burning through quick times today.
Right.
So let's do this.
Sorry it's taken us a while to get to this, but we've been so busy. Let's roll the tape.
Yeah, this thing's been around for a while. We're going to see if we can make this actual swap happen.
So for those that are unaware, this is Visk's digital frame at the top. That's a picture of Matt and myself. You can load pictures of your vacation photos that you take with your family in all white at the beach. And you can trade it for something else in the swap shop, or you can keep it. The Game Boy, as we discussed, is a hot item with Mortal Kombat's 1 and 2.
And the top item belongs to Visk, and the bottom one belongs to James. And they have been, I guess James put this out there, that he wanted the digital picture frame. So if Visk, if you're out there, you want to confirm this, give us a call. Otherwise, we'll revisit it tomorrow and see what they said, if we hear something online about it.
We'll make a successful swap if they decide it's a confirmed deal. What do you think? Would you shake hands for this? I know I would. Sometimes when I've played a video game for too long, I just want to get rid of it. And what better way than receiving a digital picture frame to share all images of yourself that cycle through like a digital billboard in your home? showing you of all the great memories you once had.
And if you really want to kind of hedge your bet, if you're James, go ahead, take a picture of you playing the Game Boy. When you get the frame, make that the first picture you put in there. So you kind of get the best of both worlds. I know what you're asking. Can it work in vertical orientation? It seems as though it's in horizontal portrait orientation. I can't answer that question, but this can, and I'm pretty sure it's going to work both ways.
All we need is a call in and find out if it's a deal. Do the handshake over the phone, and I believe this will mark our 16th deal.
2016, 16 deals. At the beginning of the year, we said 16-16 challenge. Once we hit 16 deals in 2016, Zach is going to... Remember?
Oh, that's right. I'm going to film myself in my car, driving, reading poetry.
That's right.
Call from...
As I drive through traffic.
Yes. Welcome to the swap shop.
Hello, Matt. Hello, Zach.
Hello.
How are you going today?
Is this Visk?
Visk.
Come on.
You are correct, sir.
Welcome to the swap. Back to the swap shop.
Nice to be back to see you guys. You cleaned up a bit.
Yeah. We rearranged some things. Zach got rid of some of his old figurines and pillows, and it's given us a lot of space in here.
You put a shiver robe in here.
Right. It smells great, doesn't it?
That's furniture.
It still smells great, though. We don't have any animals crawling all around it.
That's true. You get rid of the ferret. The random ferret's gone, too.
Right. You don't want animals climbing on your furniture. It's going to make it smell. Dogs, cats, I love them to death, but their fur, they get out in the rain, get that wet smell.
People come in here, they're like, what's the secret? Why does it always smell so good? Why does it make me feel so comfortable in here? And I say, cinnamon brooms. We keep about 5 or 6 cinnamon brooms, and then we just sweep up with them every day. And that's how we get that fresh-baked cookie smell that we walk around with all day.
It's truly a wonderful thing.
It really sticks with me, too, when I go home after a long, hard day. I have that cinnamon broom smell.
But you asked me to call in to confirm or not on the swap with the frame for the Game Boy.
Right.
That's correct.
And actually, I can confirm it was... made official as of 2 days ago.
Yes.
It's a deal.
It's definitely a deal.
We need some sort of graphic.
Hopefully, I'll be getting in touch with him soon because I've been waiting for him to update me on the tracking for it. And then once that's done, I should be all set for him.
Wonderful.
All right.
You remain the powerful king of swappers, Visk. I wonder if another king or queen will try and take your throne.
Usurp you.
But as of now...
Well, Visk, and the earlier today, I think Decree's trying really hard.
So.
There's been a lot of heat on Decree. Do you want to say anything to him, or is there any sort of... to the community at large you'd like to... Do you wish him well?
No,
wish
him well, of course. Okay. I wish everyone well on this. Just bring more stuff because I want to swap with everybody eventually.
Okay, the heat is on. Do you just want to do a quick handshake over the phone to commemorate the deal?
I think I can do that.
Okay.
All right. You know the deal. You've done it many times.
Yes,
and
I do.
On our mark, make a handshake sound. 1, 2,
all right.
And 3.
It's a deal.
It's a deal.
It's a deal.
Thank you for confirming that deal, Visk. And speaking of Decree, we have a...
Oh, right. We got one last little bit for
That's
today.
Right.
Sorry to make it a short call, Visk. We're running out of 3 minutes left.
Got it.
Completely understandable.
And
have a great day, guys.
See you back in the shop soon.
Congratulations on closing your deal.
Thank you very much, guys. Take care.
See ya. I like to say see ya, and I also like to text CYA. That's my favorite.
Wait.
See ya.
Yeah.
I don't say goodbye or, you know, I just say see ya.
Yeah. Okay.
So.
Decree.
Decree, yes, 2 days ago, spoke about a sword, a fantasy, and we turned it into a pitch. And this might be something we can put on something before Game of Thrones. Or, you know, if you like fantasy,
yeah.
I think you'll like this.
My favorite sword, the coolest sword I've ever seen. It's really cool. It starts off and it's got a really big handle. It's kind of got like a gold blockage around the, you know, kind of like a cutlass that has the guard, and you hold it and it's gold around it. And then as the blade goes up, silver, and it's kind of, it's not really sharp. It's more kind of like round. And then at the top, it's got like two little prongs and it's kind of shaped like a key. A lot of people call it like a keyblade.
Okay.
But I've only heard it in such fantasies and lore, but there's sometimes like a little keychain kind of hangs off. If I had to point it at somebody, that's a hard one. I probably wouldn't point it at anybody, but I would definitely use it to maybe knight somebody. Probably he'd wear a jumpsuit, probably brown or black, and it'd have his name on the top right corner. And he'd probably have a bunch of keys on a ring himself, and he'd probably be carrying like a mop.
Thank you for swapping your story, Decree, your fantasy.
We hope you have come out of there. Don't get trapped in the fantasy world. We don't want you to get hurt by another sword. A lot of people have swords in fantasy stories.
And if anybody else wants to describe a sword to us or any other thing with a gold handle on it, describe it to us. Hashtag your tweet, describe, and we'll just check for describe tweets.
That's right. And we are unfortunately out of time today in the swap shop. As always, we thank you for visiting us and stopping in. Congratulations to Visk on his successful swap, and we hope a lot more swaps go down.
And stick around for the crossword. It's a fun game with Max and Dave. And until tomorrow, it's our Big Friday farewell show.
That's right. Stay tuned tomorrow. Find out where Matt's going and watch Jock get bullied.
Don't Google my criminal record. You won't find anything.
It's a deal.
It's a deal.
That's what I'm talking about.